tone. So here we have completed module 1, 2 and 3. So in today's class we will complete module number 4. So in the module number 4 we have groundwater depletion, climate change, acid rain, ozone depletion, fluoride problem and environmental toxicity, right? So many of them had told about the length of the video, so we will decrease the length of the video this time. Weekly I will post the videos and you know how it goes, right? So module number 4, introduction. For the acid rain, what we can say is the more appropriate word for acid rain is basically acid depletion. So first reported acid rain was on 1727. So from then there was acid deposition, or also called as acid rain. In the common terms we call it as acid rain, right? Next, in 1872, Robert Smith, he is an English chemist. Because he is a chemist, he knows about the properties of acid and alkaline material, right? He named it as acid rain, right? Acids are the one with the pH below 7. Basics or alkaline are the one with pH more than 7. So what do you mean by pH? pH means potency of hydrogen, right? So in the introduction itself of acid rain, or what is going on with the acid rain, we have fossil fuels such as coal, oil, natural gas are burned, right? Chemicals, when we burn this, chemicals like sulfur dioxide and nitrogen oxide are produced, right? So combustion of fossil fuels is a bad thing, but still it's been going on because it is more easy to do so. So these chemicals react with water in the air to form sulfuric acid and nitric acid. So that sulfur dioxide and nitrogen oxide, whatever is there, and when there is rainfall, these acidic or harmful toxic gases will mix with the water and they form acid, right? So these air pollutants or acid pollutants spread upwards into the atmosphere and finally return to the ground in form of acid rain, fog or snow. Not only rain, so we get in fog or snow also. So the corrosive nature of acid rain causes many forms of environmental damage. So as you know, acid is a corrosive material, so it will cause many environmental damage. So how do we conclude that it is an acid rain? So any rain with pH below 5.7 is called as acid rain. So even in acid rain, pH as low as 2.5 has been also recorded. Right, so very strong acid has been also recorded. Industrial revolution has led us to end up in acid rain. So why basically it happened? It is because of industrial revolution. There are many processes which will be going on, and because of that, combustion of fossil fuels will be there, and because of that we get acid rain. So oxides of sulfur and nitrogen are mainly responsible for this acid rain. So these oxides, when leached by the rainwater, it is produced acid rain. So as I already told you, the nitrogen and sulfur oxides whichever are there, so they will react with the water. So because of that we will get acid rain. So they come back. Because of the pollution, there is production of harmful gases, they go up. But as there is monsoon at that time, we get those harmful gases will come back to the earth by mixing with the water and it becomes acid rain. So damage from acid rain is widespread in North America, Europe, Japan, China and Southeast Asia. In the US, coal burning plants contribute about 70% of sulfur dioxide. So coal burning is a very bad thing, right? Coal mining is a very bad thing. So right now, as you can see, the Adani group has proposed for coal mining in Goa, right? So there is too much of opposition from the people of Goa, right? So that is happening right now, as you can see. Also, coming to next point, in Canada, oil refining and other industrial activities account for 61% of sulfur dioxide pollution, right? So 70 and 61%, these are all because of industries and burning of fossil fuels itself. Also, motor vehicles exhaust fumes that are the main source of nitrogen oxides, right? Even the vehicles which are there, which we drive, even that is causing acid rain. So what are the effects of acid rain? Mainly, the acid or sulfur or nitrogen, mainly sulfur dioxide and nitrogen oxides to be specific. So it dissolves and washes away nutrients in the soil, right, which is needed by the plants. Also, it flows as groundwater to reach rivers, lakes and wetlands to make water acidic. If water is acidic, the aquatic life can't survive. Also, it damages buildings, automobiles and other structures made of stone and metal. Right, acid is a corrosive material, as I told you earlier, and it damages buildings, you know, historical monuments, etc. Acid, along with other chemicals in air, produces smog, which causes respiratory problems. Right. So smoke with fog is called as smog. So it also has far-reaching effects in wildlife. It disturbs food chain, or it disrupts food chain. Right. So you know what do you mean by food chain, right? So in the wildlife, we can come to a point, or we can see an actual image how it is affected, right? All the leaves have been, you know, corroded, and the trees, whatever are there, are specifically dead. Also, there is destruction of monuments too, right? So as you can see, it is made up of white marble, and because of the acid rain, there is an industry which is situated near to Taj Mahal, and because of that, cause of acid rain has happened, and because of that, there was a huge effect on Taj Mahal. So what could be done for controlling of acid rain, right? Cleaning of smokestacks and exhaust pipes can be done, right, using alternate energy resources. So that's why more and more alternative or renewable energy resources are into scientific research, which are more reasonable, are into scientific research, because burning of fossil fuels is a bad thing, right, and it causes, it is the main cause for acid rain. Also, we can do is cleaning of smokestacks and exhaust pipes too. So next topic, as I told you, it was about ozone depletion. So there is a hole in ozone layer, right?